So today we will be studying propagation of electromagnetic waves in conducting medium. Again, we start with the Maxwell's equations. And of course, these relations you must be familiar by all these relations by now. And for a conducting medium, we will take rho is equal to zero. This means now the equations that we will be having will be we will label these equations as 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now from these two equations, from equations 2 and 4, what we have is del dot H is equal to 0 and del cross E is equal to minus mu del H by del T. We will take curl of equation 3. This is del cross H is equal to left hand side will be reduced to del dot H is from this equation. Del dot H is 0. We will substitute the value of del cross E from this equation. We will rearrange the terms. we label this equation as equation A. Here we have two terms. This term comes from the conduction current, and this term comes from the displacement current. Now, what we did, here we have taken curl of equation 3, curl of this equation. Now we will take curl of equation 4. And using the similar method as we did for the previous equation, we will follow the same method and we will arrive at the equation and we call this equation as equation B. So equations A and equation B together are known as equations of telegraphy. Can anybody of you tell me why they are called the equations of telegraphy? Are you getting me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Don't engage yourself in noting down. I will be putting this video on YouTube. You can write it from there also. Now, since you notice that equation A and B are identical in all the respects except the fields. Only the difference between equation A and B is the field H and E. So we can learn, write a general equation . What does this equation represent? What kind of a wave it will be? It will be an attenuated wave. Attenuated in the sense that the intensity of the relevant field will gradually get damped. It will decrease and ultimately it will reduce to a certain value. So what you call damping in while studying oscillations, here we called it as attenuation. Attenuation is any damping or any hindrance produced in the flow of the current or the fields. The general solution for this kind of an equation is where K is a complex quantity. So, taking a clue from this, we can write the solutions for the fields as now we substitute the value of these fields from equation C in equations and B. And since they are similar equations, so again we will write a generalized equation.
So please explain question C again.
Just a second. Equation C is simply a generalized assumed wave solution. Like you see from this equation, you have a general solution of this form. Taking clue from this, we have just assumed that the field E and H will have a solution of this form. This will be the amplitude E0 and H0 corresponding to Xi0 here, and the oscillatory part is as such. This is an assumed solution. This you must have studied while studying the damped oscillations and in mathematics also. Yeah, this is an assumed solution. This is a standard one. So this is a generalized equation that we arrive at. So both the equations are same. The only difference is in E and H. So I have written it in one shot. These fields can't be zero. Can this field be zero? क्या ये फील्ड जीरो हो सकती हैं? दे कांट बी जीरो, सो द क्वांटिटी इन दिस ब्रैकेट विल बी जीरो. दैट मींस के स्क्वायर दिस विल बी जीरो. सो वी गेट के स्क्वायर right now. I had written k is complex quantity. From here you can see this is the real part, this is the imaginary part. K is complex. Since I have said that k is a complex quantity, so I can write it in the form alpha plus I beta, where alpha is the real part and beta is the imaginary part. So I will put this value of k in equation 7a, just I have written. I substituted the value of k in equation 7a. Just expand this k square and equate the real and imaginary part on both the sides. This is the real part and this is the imaginary. So we get these two equations. Now what is the method of solving? ये method आप लोग पढ़ चुके हैं. एक से beta की value निकालेंगे, दूसरे में substitute करेंगे. I will put the value of beta from this expression into this one. क्या हो जाएगा? This alpha square, beta की value यहां से यहां रखेंगे. It will be mu square sigma square omega square upon 4 alpha square. Equation 8 will become this. Substituting beta from equation 9 in equation 8. Rearranging the terms, alpha to the power 4 I multiplied the equation by alpha square. Now this equation is a quadratic in alpha square. So what will be the value of alpha square? So if this is alpha square, then alpha will be 0, mu tending to mu 0, epsilon tending to epsilon 0, this equation 7a and 7b gives me this question. We will write this. Now, substituting the alpha in this equation, we get the value of beta as instead of k, I will write alpha plus I beta dot r. Since k is alpha plus I beta and n is the unit vector, I will separate these two terms, this r dependent and t dependent terms. Or rather, the real and imaginary terms, exponential this is the real, this is the imaginary. The phase velocity. I will substitute the value of alpha here. जो निकाली हमने अल्फा की वैल्यू if this quantity is much greater than 1, then we can apply binomial theorem. Refractive index is defined as C upon V. Substituting the value of V from there, this equation. I get the refractive index. Yahan pe refractive index, is it real or imaginary or complex? Bataiye dekhke. हेलो
हाँ जी सर
हाँ ये यहाँ पे वैल्यू ऑफ रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज इट रियल और इमेजिनरी और कॉम्प्लेक्स
इट इज रियल सर
इट्स रियल
क्योंकि क्वांटिटीज म्यू सिग्मा विल ऑलवेज बी रियल ओमेगा इज इन द रियल पार्ट ओमेगा कांट बी इमेज्ड Now, just look. At the value of beta. Beta will increase or decrease. Beta key tendency. Will it increase with time or it will decrease with time? Just notice this sign and tell me.
So decrease.
So it will decrease.
Okay. So since beta will decrease, so we can say that it is a measure of damping or attenuation here. एंड बीटा को हम लोग we call it absorption coefficient. We make one more substitution, and dot R is equal to del from this equation. At the surface, we can approximate this exponential to be 1. So, at the surface, the value of this kind of a field where this is the measure of distance. So, at the surface, it is E0, the field is E0. When we travel a distance given by delta, the value of the field becomes E delta. So, delta is the distance or depth of the medium by traveling which the value of the field is reduced by 1 upon E. You got it? If I go this much of delta depth inside the matter, the field will drop by 1 upon E, by a factor of 1 upon E. One upon E key value approximately kitni hoti hai?
0.37, sir.
0.369. So this delta is called skin depth and is defined as the depth or the length inside or the length inside the matter where traveling where which the value of the field is reduced by one upon by a factor of 1 upon E. Now, since we have got the values of alpha and beta with us, alpha beta ki value hum nikal chuke hain, we can now know the exact fields. Nikalne ki zarurat nahi hai, but since now we know the value of alpha and beta, so we can also calculate the value of the exact fields. Aur fields ki value nikal ke what we will do? अगर हम वैल्यू ई और एच की सपोज आई कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ ई एंड एच बाय सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ अल्फा एंड बीटा इन इक्वेशन 11 आई विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ दीज फील्ड्स सो फ्रॉम दिस आई कैन कैलकुलेट सो व्हाट आर द कंक्लूजंस यू गेट from what we did today, that wave gets attenuated with penetration in the medium wave retains its transverse character transverse with respect to E and H The value of H will be greater than E as H lags in phase. This is due to the value of alpha and beta.